प्रोफेसर सी डी देशमुख वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोलॉजी ऑफ स्कूल ऑफ फार्मेसी अंडर MIT वर्ल्ड पीस यूनिवर्सिटी पुणे. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट यू डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन कंटेंट ऑफ आवर ओन ब्लड सैंपल. फॉर दैट रीजन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस व्हाट इज हीमोग्लोबिन. हीमोग्लोबिन इज नथिंग बट अ आयरन कंटेनिंग प्रोटीन इन अ ह्यूमन ब्लड. ह्यूमन ब्लड इज ऑल्सो कंपोज ऑफ RBCs, WBCs, प्लेटलेट ऑफ विच RBCs आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेल्स इन अ ब्लड. RBCs कंटेन्स हीमोग्लोबिन एंड द मेन रोल ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन इज टू ट्रांसफर द ऑक्सीजन टू वेरियस सेल्स ऑफ अ बॉडी, वेरियस टिश्यूज ऑफ अ बॉडी, सो दैट ऑल सेल्स, ऑल टिश्यूज आर परफॉर्मिंग देयर फंक्शन करेक्टली इन अ ह्यूमन बॉडी. नाउ टूडे द नॉर्मल लेवल ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन इज डिफरेंट इन डिफरेंट एज पीपल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन मेन हीमोग्लोबिन इज प्रेजेंट इन अ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ 13-18 ग्राम पर लीटर. देन इन वुमेन हीमोग्लोबिन इज प्रेजेंट इन बिटवीन अ रेंज ऑफ 12-16.5 ग्राम्स पर डेसीलीटर. देन इन चिल्ड्रन अबाउट 1 years ऑफ एज द हीमोग्लोबिन इज प्रेजेंट इन अ रेंज ऑफ 11-13 ग्राम्स पर डेसीलीटर. देन चिल्ड्रन अप टू 10-12 years ऑफ एज हीमोग्लोबिन इज प्रेजेंट इन अ रेंज ऑफ 11.5-14.5 ग्राम्स पर डेसीलीटर. एंड इन इन्फंट हीमोग्लोबिन इज प्रेजेंट इन अ रेंज ऑफ 13.5-19.5 ग्राम्स पर डेसीलीटर. दिस इज द नॉर्मल रेंज ऑफ हीमोग्लोबिन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द एज. नाउ whenever this hemoglobin are reduced, that time a person is suffering from disease called as anemia, and that anemia is having various symptoms such as weakness is there, the patient is unable to perform the daily activities are there, and for that reason the measurement of this hemoglobin concentration is very much important. Now hemoglobin concentration is also increased in some cases such as hemoconcentration. In a hemoconcentration due to a blood loss in severe diarrhea and vomiting, that time also hemoglobin is increased in the human body or in RBCs. Further, hemoglobin are also increased in certain type of congenital heart diseases, okay, and or hemoglobin concentration is also increased in polycythemia or emphysema. Sometimes hemoglobin concentration is reduced in the pregnancy or lactation. So the lady who is pregnant, okay, in that lady there is a less concentration of hemoglobin. So due to the less concentration of hemoglobin, what will happen? Various cells and tissues are not receiving oxygen in sufficient amount, and thereby that lady is suffering from various diseases due to this hemoglobin deficiency in human body. So for that reason, whenever you have any blood related diseases, for example polycythemia, for example emphysema, blood cancer, or any other type of infectious diseases such as malaria, TB, typhoid, AIDS, that time a doctor is mandatorily prescribing us to go for certain blood related test in which hemoglobin is very important parameter. In this experiment we are going to determine the normal hemoglobin of a body, whether it is a normal or not we will going to discuss. So this type of experiment is requiring certain chemicals, instrument, glassware, okay. So first I will demonstrate what kind of instruments are requiring in this hemoglobin experiment. We are requiring this Sahalitz, this is called as, entire instrument is called as hemoglobinometer. This hemoglobinometer consisting of one instrument which is called as comparator. This comparator is consisting of a brown glass mounted, and this is called as comparator. So we are going to compare the normal, whatever the hemoglobin values we are there, we are determining that values are comparing by color with this help of standard comparator which is there in this comparator box. Then we are also having certain other instrument in that hemoglobinometer such as graduated tube. This is called as graduated tube, which is requiring. This graduated tube is composed of one rubber tube which is attached to this glass tube. so it is entirely it is called as graduated tube. This tube is essential for drawing the blood or collecting blood through this for this experiment. Then we are going one more instrument is there, which is called as HB tube. This is called as HB tube, in which we are going to take HCl as well as blood in order to compare with the standard comparator which is there in this instrument. Then further we are also requiring the dropper for the collection of various samples, and we are also requiring the stirrer which is there for the stirring the sample which is there in this HB tube. Okay, so this is how the instrument is requiring for this particular experiment. Okay, regarding the chemicals, we are requiring the chemicals such as hydrochloric acid, which is there, it is prepared just recently. We are also requiring some sort of distilled water, and we are also requiring the spirit for the disinfectant of a finger before drawing the blood from the volunteer. We are also requiring beaker here, and we are also requiring the cotton in order to disinfect the finger. So coming to the next, we are also requiring certain lancet for pricking. This is the lancet, I will show you. I will tear it off and I will show you how the lancet is appearing. This is small needle is there, in this way this lancet is appearing. So this lancet is important for pricking the finger of a volunteer for collection of a blood. Okay, this lancet is important for pricking the finger for collection of a blood. Coming to the next, we will go to the principle of this experiment. Okay, so principle is that whenever a blood is added to 0.1 normal HCl, this is a HCl, whenever we are adding the blood to this 0.1 normal HCl, which we will be taking in this tube, that time hemoglobin which is there in the blood, that hemoglobin is converted into the brown colored acid that is called as hematin. Okay, so when we are first going to take this HCl in this tube, in the procedure about 20% HCl we are going to take, and we are adding the blood samples in this tube. Okay, so after adding the blood samples, the blood is reacting with that HCl, and there is a production of one acid which is called as hematin. The resulting color after dilution, then we are further adding the distilled water in this reaction mixture, so that whatever color is formed, that color we are going to compare with the help of standard color which is there in this comparator box, this color. And finally whenever color is matching, okay, that time we will be drawing that result, what much percentage of hemoglobin is there in our human body. Okay, so in this way this is the principle of hemoglobinometer. Now we are going to move ahead with the procedure of this experiment. So one by one I will show you a procedure. Okay, so first of all, in the procedure we are going to add 0.1 normal HCl in the graduated tube up to the lowest mark, that is a 20%. If you are observing closely here, then there is a 20% mark is there. Okay, in the 20% I am going to add HCl. So HCl is there in this, we are going to take this HCl with the help of this dropper. We are going to take HCl and we are going to add in this with this dropper. HCl is added up to 20% mark. After that we are closing this bottle. We are keeping this tube in the comparator in this way. Then we are going to disinfecting the blood of a volunteer with the help of this spirit. So we are taking here, we are opening the spirit bottle, we are taking this spirit in the beaker, and we are dropping this cotton in this spirit, and we are trying to disinfect the finger of a volunteer. In this way we are disinfecting the finger. Then we are pricking the finger and we are drawing the blood. So this blood which have been drawn, we are taking in this graduated hemoglobin tube up to this mark. The mark is there in this graduated tube, there is one mark. Up to this mark we are taking the blood, okay? Yes. Without the bubbles, we are taking a precaution that bubble is not there. That blood we have taken, and that blood we are going to add in this graduated tube in the SCL. In this way, we have added whatever blood is there in the graduated tube in this hemoglobin tube, okay? So the brownish color, if you are observing, it is form, okay? Later on, we are keeping this tube in the comparator box, and whatever the bubbles are there, there are no bubbles here in this tube, so we are keeping it as it is. Whatever the excess of a blood is there, we are going to wipe if any excess of blood, but there is no any excess of a blood here, so there is no question of wiping. Mix the reaction. Then we are going to keep this as it is for the 10 minutes. Whatever the this tube we have placed here in the comparator, then we are keeping this for 10 minutes, and after that we are going to add certain distilled water here. Before 10 minutes, we have added this blood sample to the 0.1 normal SCL, and this reaction mixture was kept for 10 minutes. Now 10 minutes have been finished, and I am going to, after this, we are going to add some sort of distilled water in this reaction mixture with the help of dropper. So I am slowly adding the distilled water in the reaction mixture in order to determine the hemoglobin level. Slowly I am going to add, and I'm going to stirring this distilled water and blood mixture with the help of this stirrer. Still the color of this reaction mixture is much concentrated, so I'm going to add further this, and I'm going to, after addition, some sort of color, I'm keeping this hemoglobin tube in the comparator box in order to compare the mixture. So still this the hemoglobin is darker, so still the hemoglobin is darker here. So again I am going to add the distilled water slowly with the help of this drop, with the help of this dropper. I am again going to add this distilled water slowly with the help of this dropper. Now the color of that tube is much closer to that of comparator box. So in this way I am going to dissolve again. Some sort of distilled water is still essential, so I am going to add one more drop, and we will again see whether the drop is compared or not. It is not still, the color is not still same. I am going to stir the reaction mixture again, and I am going to put one more drop of distilled water here. I am going to put one more drop of reaction mixture. Now you can see the reaction mixture or the blood sample is almost closer to that of comparator, but one more drop is essential. So I have added one more drop. Now if you observe the color of this reaction mixture and the color of the this comparator is almost same, okay. So we will see what kind of hemoglobin percentage is there. So from this hemoglobin percentage, here is quite more. For example, hemoglobin percentage here is 12 gram per deciliter. This is a yellow marking, so 10 gram per deciliter, whatever the level is there, so it will come to the 12 mark per deciliter. So in this way, the volunteer blood is having hemoglobin concentration 12 gram per deciliter. So this is how we have demonstrated how hemoglobin is, how much percentage of hemoglobin is there in the volunteer's blood sample. So I thank you very much for this patiently attending my practical session. Thank you very much.